A reading from the Gospel of Luke. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, favored one. The Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father. And he will rule over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month for her who was called barren, for nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord. At the Annunciation, Mary gave her fiat to God's request. From her yes, we can learn three very important lessons. The first being, God loves us without condition, a love that is beyond human understanding. Sometimes it may seem hard for us to accept this kind of love. Other times, we may ask how we can be certain of God's love. If we consider the story of the Annunciation, we have our answer. God didn't have to send Jesus. Jesus didn't have to become a human. But he did, because God loves us that much. Not just as one great mass of people, but each one of us individually and without end. Through Mary, God sent us his absolute greatest gift of love, his son Jesus. The second lesson is about humility. Learning to be humble means learning to be small in the eyes of the world, being truly submissive to God's will and being modest in everything. It's a tall order. But we don't need to look any further than Mary to find the perfect example of humility. She shows us that it's worth the struggle for a reward that's eternal. However, humility doesn't mean pretending you aren't valuable or that you don't have worth. Humility lies in recognizing our value and also in recognizing that our value rests not in our own deeds, but in God's love for us. The third lesson points to the help God gives us in carrying the weight of our own yes. It's easy to forget how hard Mary's life must have been when we see her portrayed so serenely and otherworldly in art. Yet her yes weighed heavily for her entire life. From the scrapes and bruises of her everyday life in Nazareth, to the struggle at the foot of the cross and the tears outside the empty tomb. From the moment of her fiat to her assumption into heaven, Mary had to rely on God's aid, just as each one of us must do. Mary's secret strength is no secret at all. It was her unfailing trust in God. God gave her the strength she needed, but she had to say yes to his help. She blazed a trail for all of us, showing us just how to say yes. She showed us how to change the world, one fiat at a time. Mary might be described as the first lady of the church. She was chosen by God and was essentially the very first disciple of Jesus. In the church's images of Mary, we see a young and beautiful woman with flawless skin and an angelic face. Yet she must have been terribly frightened by this strange turn of events. And despite the fear of this unknown, she still chose to say yes to God. God chose Mary to be mother of Jesus because of her beautiful heart and her deep faith, not because she was physically the most beautiful. We really don't know for sure what Mary looked like, but we do know that Mary chose to dedicate her life to God, and has, as such, is a role model for all Christian women and men. Mary, in her affirmative response to be God's servant, became the very first disciple. She took a leap of faith, placed her trust in God, and willingly placed her life in his hands. It is unfortunate that we learn very little of Mary in sacred scripture, but we do learn of her active role in God's mission to save the world. Not only did she bear the Son of God, mother him and raise him, but she knows she was present for some of his very first miracles. Her faith never wavered, even at the foot of the cross. She bore Jesus to us. Now we are called to bear Jesus in the world. Mary was our first example how to live as a disciple. Look to her for strength and grace as you journey your own path of discipleship. With God's help and Mary's example, you too can live as Christ's disciple. Mary, model of gentleness, be our guide. Mary, model of trust, be our guide. Mary, model of patience, be our guide. Mary, model of openness, be our guide. Mary, model of perseverance, be our guide.